Namaskar. Today, without wasting out much time, let's come to the much more valued and important discussion of the reasons and facts about Dr. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee as a non-communal, selfless nationalist. As in our previous episodes, we have gone through and known many more facts about Dr. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee's life and his political life too. Now, we are going to discuss that both Fazlul Haq and Shyamaprasad Mukherjee was not at all communal, neither in their view nor in their intentions, as both of them wanted upliftment of the general mass of India and especially of the backward section. Now, many people are there who say Dr. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee was a communalist. But we know that truth is sometimes very different from what we believe, especially in politics and history. As the first major incident of communal violence was the Mopla Rebellion of August 1921, after Mahatma Gandhi called off the non-cooperation movement, leading to large scale of violence against Hindus and their subsequent displacement in the Malabar region. Jinnah's direct action that carved on religious lines is an action that inflamed communal passions, resulting in the worst communal riots that British India had ever seen. And Jinnah's demand had claimed thousands of victims, thereby eventually sowing the seeds for the partition of India. Here's Dr. B.R. Ambedkar in his book of Pakistan or the Partition of India. He wrote that Jinnah, who was never known to be a very devout, pious or a professing Muslim, later transformed into a mass leader of the Muslims and became not only a believer of Islam but was also prepared to die for it. Jinnah's simple strategy and principle of mobilizing the Muslim masses not only achieved his objective but also ensured that his ideology became a part and parcel of the overall mental makeup of the Muslims, a price which Pakistan has been paying since 1947. In a letter to Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald in September 1932, Gandhi wrote, in the establishment of separate electorates at all for the depressed class. I sense the injection of poison that is calculated to destroy Hinduism. As Ambedkar demanded for separate electorates for the untouchables, and this led to the clash between Gandhi and Ambedkar. As once in Gandhi's sayings in the meeting of the Federal Structure Committee held on September 17, 1931, of strongly resisting of further any special representation. Ambedkar remarks, "This was nothing but a declaration of war by Mr. Gandhi and the Congress against the untouchables." As Muhammad Ali Jinnah was seemed to be foremost responsible among the Indian politicians who had started the communal division, whereas Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru made their silenced views to propagate Indian communal strategy.
Some important questions. Why the Congress was not a force to reckon with among the masses of Bengal in the 1940s? Why was the peasantry of Bengal alienated from the Congress that had organized mass anti-imperialist movements across the country in 1905, 1921-22 and 1930-32? Unless the story of this mass alienation from the Congress in Bengal is recounted, it is impossible to fully comprehend how the Muslim League emerged as the most important party of the Bengali Muslims in the space of a few years. If present unrest was ultimately articulated in communal ideology.
On 19th of September 1945, following negotiations between Indian leaders and members of the 1946 Cabinet Mission to India from the United Kingdom, the Viceroy Lord Wavell announced that elections to the provincial and central legislatures would be held in December 1945 to January 1946. It was also announced that an executive council would be formed and a constitution-making body would be convened after these elections. Now, these elections were important as the provincial assemblies thus formed were to then elect a new constituent assembly which would begin formulating a constitution for an independent India. All contesting parties began campaigning. The Congress contended that it represented the entire Indian population, while the Muslim League professed to speak for the whole Muslim population. The dominant issue of the election campaign became the issue of Pakistan.
Gandhi had already become irrelevant to the vast majority of Indians and Pakistanis. It may always be added as an afterthought. In 1946-47, Quit India in 1942 and the Sterile-belated talks with Jinnah in 1944 were Gandhi's individual decisions. Was there any point in virtually conceding Pakistan and denying the two-nation theory at the same time? The Quit India resolution, it is well known, did not have the support of all congressmen and ended up removing the Congress from the center stage of Indian politics during the war. While the talks with the sole spokesman ended up enhancing Jinnah's stature and legitimizing his communal claims even among several Muslims who could still be called Congress supporters in 1944, both instances demonstrated serious flaws in a movement over which a single and often momentarily ill-informed patriot had so much influence. In the ultimate analysis, Gandhi's moral authority could neither substitute nor overcome the collective failure of the Congress leadership in dealing with the communal question.
Dear friends and all my colleagues, I would first of all like to thank on behalf of Shyama Prasad Enlightenment Federation. Every weekly basis as we are appearing with these new episodes, which is related to Dr. Shyama Prasad. These videos are very crucial. Not only crucial, this is, you can say, the precious things, because it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of analysis to bring out all these kind of videos. And as you all know, guys, that this is the time for the COVID-19, due to which we do not have that much resources that we can definitely go ahead and support these videos. Henceforth, it's a hard time for us. We would request everyone to support and cooperate with us and to share these videos as much as you can from your end. And you can, guys, go ahead and view it as we would love to take your feedbacks, guys, because that's one of the valuable things. We have the Facebook channel, Facebook group over there with the Shyama Prasad Enlightenment Federation. We have the YouTube channel with the national icon. We are on the Instagram also. So guys, we just want your cooperation with us at this part of time, because resources are very less. However, we know that we need to improve a lot, but it will take certain time. So we would definitely say beg us for this, or pardon us for this time, and support us so that we can make more beautiful videos. Coming episode, right, you guys will be able to see a fantastic artist will be there, right, who you'll be guys hearing them, that how the song was actually sung. So that's all from my end, guys. Thank you so much for today. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.